Listening Library presents Archivist Wasp by Nicole Kornher-Stace, read for you by Abby Craden. Prologue. The knife. She'd lost the knife. Now she was as good as dead. Frantically, she scanned the sand around her. No knife. How far off could it have landed? She squinted to see farther out, but the crowd's torches were too far back for the blade to catch their light. She swore under her breath. Fractions of a second passed while she, Wasp, 3 years archivist and terror of the upstarts, actually froze. They were probably the last fractions of a second she had left. There was a pause as the other girl, this year's third and final upstart, realized what had happened. As the crowd began to shout, an archivist disarmed. The catch-keep priest in his high chair raked his gaze across them, and their shouts hushed to murmuring, showing the archivist choosing day its due respect. Still, out of the corner of her eye, Wasp could see spectators jostling to the front of the ring, parents lifting children on their shoulders for a better view. She knew there'd be a few in the crowd secretly betting now. Would she try to fight unarmed? Would she run? Would she stand unmoving in her pride and let the upstart cut her throat? The upstart staggered to her feet, bleeding freely from half a dozen wounds, and bobbed behind her own knife, watching Wasp cagily. Still, Wasp stood there, her pulse banging at her wounds, sweat cooling on her skin. Somehow, it was almost a relief. It wasn't like she'd ever thought she'd die easy. That was a luxury archivists weren't really allowed. Getting it out of the way now might not be so bad. She thought on what she'd miss in those last moments, bleeding out into the sand. It wasn't a long list. Not a split second too soon, reflex grabbed her, dragged her back. The upstart's blade slashed the air a thumb's width from her jaw. The slick hiss of its passage sounded daunted. It had meant to empty out her throat. Dumb luck. It couldn't last. The upstart was getting cocky now, slashing wide and wild, riding high on the vision of Wasp's death and her own ascension to archivist in Wasp's place. And Wasp had to fling herself back hard from the next swing. Not hard enough. The knife point caught her lip. She tasted blood. Momentum and lightheadedness caught her feet in the sand, and she faltered a few steps and went down. The crowd's sudden silence beat at her like wings. Respect for the goddess Catchkeep, whose ritual this was. But respect, too, for Catchkeep's archivist, soon to die. Soon enough, they'd be dragging her from the sand, reading the holy words over her as her corpse was sectioned out like an orange. Meat for Catchkeep's shrine dogs. Powdered bones for the planted fields. A skull on the shrine wall with a green stone in its mouth. The bloodied sand of her drag trail scraped up and kept for luck. And Wasp would dwindle in their sight until she was no monster any longer. Not marked from birth as Catchkeep's own and holy. Just a girl with a knife, infinitely breakable. And for days they'd amuse each other with the story of that breaking. But she knew all this already. It was a decision she'd been making over and over for 3 years now, and she always reached the same conclusion. She hated being archivist. Hated being forced to choose between killing upstarts to keep the sacred role she'd grown so tired of and letting herself be killed so that the upstart who killed her could take up that role when she was dead. But if there was one thing she was terrible at doing, it was giving up. "Use your head, you carrion," she commanded herself. "You relic. Think." She'd lashed out. Her blade had bitten deep, then skittered against ribs, caught and twisted, flung. She had not heard it land. If she went looking for it now, she'd just get tripped and gutted like a deer. She'd have to improvise. The upstart hung back, unsure. It wasn't for nothing that Wasp had been archivist for so long. Even with Wasp disarmed, blood-drenched, and downed, the upstart was still one wrong move from having the hair cut off her corpse's head and interwoven into Wasp's many-colored braids, a trophy among trophies. Far above, the 16 stars of Catchkeep's constellation twinkled down on Wasp, all innocence. She ignored them. So Catchkeep's ritual trapped her here, staring down her death, as sure as if she had her eye pressed to the barrel of a gun. She didn't have to like it. Meantime, the upstart seemed to have reached her decision. She began half stumbling, half charging at Wasp, moving like she had shackles on her ankles and a mad dog at her heels. She had the knife gripped out at arm's length, elbows locked. No art in it. No grace. She needed none. She only had to fall. Like a ghost to a salt lick, Wasp thought. Stupid as snot. Wasp waited for her moment, then kicked out hard. Heard something in the upstart's leg give way. The upstart cried out and plunged down, knife first. Her aim knocked perilously out of true. Wasp caught her mid-fall, one knee in her ribs, one fist in her hair, and eased the upstart down to kneeling. One leg splayed out at an ugly angle, but the upstart made no sound. The upstart's knife hand snapped up, too quick to draw a gasp from the crowd, and Wasp snatched her wrist and broke it. She caught the knife as it fell free. She seized a handful of the upstart's hair and the upstart flinched away, expecting her own knife in the throat. But Wasp only wiped the blade clean on the upstart's ponytail. Then palmed the hilt, still slick with fear sweat, and watched the girl thoughtfully. What she was supposed to do at this point was cut the upstart down, preserving her role as archivist unchallenged for another year. For 3 years, she had done precisely that. She could still see the face of every upstart she'd killed. Still woke from dreams in which they died all over again. Woke nauseous and sweaty and scrubbing invisible blood from her hands. She was sick of it. She was beyond sick of it. There had to be another way. So many eyes on her. The crowds, the Catchkeep priests, the upstarts, Catchkeeps herself. Wasp kept her straight ahead. She turned and walked to the edge of the sand and threw the upstart's knife as far as she could into the lake. It flew out into the dark and splashed. Voices behind her, outraged now, calling for a bloodletting, as was Catchkeep's necessity and the people's right. If the ritual had ever ended before with two girls alive, Wasp didn't know when, and it seemed the crowd didn't either. Well, let them squawk. She was done listening. The upstart had stayed where she had fallen, hugging her wrist and screaming through her teeth. She gathered like a cornered hare as Wasp approached, but did not try to run. Some pride in that, thought Wasp, used to chasing upstarts across the sand as they fled her knife. Wasp stood looking down at the upstart. She wondered if the upstart had gone into the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.